Hello, world. Welcome to the allergy stream, is what this probably be. I should take a Claritin. I think I may have one around here. I should really take a Claritin. I'll be right back. This is an awesome way to start the stream. Wait, I'm just going to start over. Yeah, I'm going to start over. Be right back. So I really should do this. And now we're starting. This is the official start of the start. I have the window open, which is maybe gonna make it a little warm in here and a little allergy in here. So I don't know what the Twitch policy is on taking drugs on screen. Allergy drugs, whatever, meds. I didn't choke to death on stream. Cool. So today what we're gonna do is find PyCharm. Or spell length right, which is something clearly I have problems with. And G lengths. There you go. So we're working on the NASA video thingamabob that makes the automatic NASA videos for us. And it's in pretty good shape. Like it's pretty solid right now. But there's a few things that I want to do with it. I don't think these are the new ones. Are these the new ones? Tough to tell. Let's see if it fades out at the end. No, see, that doesn't fade out. So that's not a new one. So I added fade in and fade out. Switch video, log output so you see what's up in each clip. Here's the things we're gonna work on. And wait, the random transitions. Set up random times for the transitions. Dying seagull in the background there. Not my favorite. Oh, it's literally called Bird Therapist. Yeah, we're gonna take that one all the way out of rotation. Just gonna go ahead and delete that. So we've got the transitions going. And we've got the clips going. So let me see where we're gonna dig into this. This is gonna take me a minute to kind of get my head back around this stuff and get going in it again. And this code got uglier than I wanted to have. This is a lot happening here. For a little method. Oh, it's just, but I'm not at the point yet where I'm gonna refactor. Cause it's, some of it's tricky to test and some of it's just whatever. Maybe that'll be an exercise is going through and refactoring, but right now I just want to get the thing done. And I've gotten way better at testing by doing this process. So like I'm cool with where we're at. So the concat command, and we've got the scene list append clip count. Here's the build concat JSON. Really kind of what we need to pass to concat JSON is, yeah, and some of this is like randomness involved. So like, it's tough to test the randomness. I don't have a good way to test the randomness yet. How do you test randomness? It's gonna be like separation stuff. I don't wanna test if something is random. I wanna, this is probably better. Run tests of randomness. Oops, new window, missed a new tab. There we go. How'd you write a simple yet robust unit test to make sure that it is working? Yeah, this is still. Problem with testing randomness is that there isn't an expected value for most of the things you'd like to test. You can test with a given seed, but that only tests repeatability. Oh, that's right. So you could pass a seed to it and have the thing always do the same thing. That's right. But again, I'm going to just kind of plow at this point. Yeah, and also like I'm just rolling straight through and like just building the output of the file. Why is that up there? Kind of stuck in my head right now. Because build concat JSON. Probably up here. Build concat JSON. So we've got all these transition types. And we've got our transitions. Or an empty list for the transition. We append a random transition type to it. So like, do you really go about testing this stuff? I don't know. Make sure transitions aren't larger than clips. Currently at 3 seconds. Yeah, so well, so I'm part of this too, I'm trying to figure out the output. So like if it's a 2 second clip, I kind of want it to smash cut. So let me just pass in a durations list. And again, this is just like, I just, all this stuff fell apart in terms of trying to stay whatevered. So we've got the scene list, but that doesn't tell us the durations. CSV file, we grab a random CSV file. Data frame from the CSV file, get the number of scenes. If there's no scene, just skip it. Then grab a scene ID. Clip duration. Get duration for clip. Scene path, scene. Okay, yeah, so we got our clip duration there. So what we could do Yeah, I shouldn't have made this a list. I should have made it a I very rarely like lists of just things. I usually do lists of dictionaries so that I can then add more stuff to the dictionary item if I need to. Not rarely, but like it, that often proves to be a valuable thing. So durations. See. All right, we'll just do it. Durations, append. Clip duration. And then here we're gonna pass durations. Yeah, oh, see, this is, I don't have a good, I don't know where to go without testing this. Build concat JSON. How would you, like, how do you even do that? With all this randomness in there. Test MP3 file. So one, I know that I should just be returning it and then writing it. Cause that'll give me, like, I can go look at the data, right? So why don't we pull that out and do that? Let's get this in there while it's in play. So I want to get let's just do this. All right. See if we can get our hooks into testing. Like, you don't figure out how to test it until you try and test it, right? Build concat JSON. All right, I'm not going to worry about the things that I don't know yet. That's part of what's catching me right now, is I keep thinking, like, how do I test this part in a second? Just focus on getting something going. Like, expected equals, and like at this point, just a raw JSON. Oh, but it's gotta be a, this JSON has to be a list, which I don't like, or an array, whatever. Assert equal expected actual. So that'll pass. So step one, we gotta test passing for build concat JSON that doesn't actually call it or do anything with it. So I'm gonna, yeah, so I've commented that out. So now I can just run it. So I'm just gonna run it to make sure the thing compiles. Which we kind of already know it does, but this is just the process of doing the test. MP3 build concat JSON. Ah, we do need to. So this is going to fail because we got to pass it a couple things. Length equals 5. Durations equals. Well, actually, I'm just going to do length equals 2, durations equals 5. So I like trying to get as small a payload as possible to be able to test. So it's as small as possible, but no smaller. Scene length, maybe. What's the Oh, did I spell it wrong again? L-A-N-G-T-H. Yep, I did. That is a hard one for me to do. So that should pass. And then if we go actual equals this, we're going to fail because we're not passing anything back. That's no problem. Yeah, okay, we'll figure this out. Transition JSON equals JSON dump s. So yeah. We want that to go as a string. Okay, I'm okay with this. I'm getting farther away from green than I want to, really, but like I think this will be okay, right? Because that's that. Ideally, I would have made this pass. Yeah, so like really, we would make this pass. Ooh, especially because that didn't work. Ah, because I put it in quotes. We're not looking for a string. Oh, we are looking for a string, but we're not. We're gonna flip it back. Okay, is this passing? Test pass. Okay. It's taking a long time to run. So this goes back as a string of JSON, not as objects. So this should fail. But now, if we do JSON load string, because I don't want to try and like make the string match exactly up here. That's going to be tedious. We need JSON up here. For JSON. Did not work. That's frustrating. So because JSON loads, it turns it just into well, I guess if we do this, I still don't totally have my head around I guess it's a JSON type object, right? Also failed. Okay, now I'm super confused. Is there a white space back here somewhere? I mean, come on. Oh, it's gonna be one of them days. So I'm dumping it. And then I'm loading it with exactly the same thing. Is it because it's not actually the same object? Click to see the difference. Right. Oh wait, it was just dir, sorry. Dir of expected print dir actual. I just want to see if I can see what's going on. Add class. It ends up with insert, pop, remove, sort. Yeah, okay, so this has all kinds of extra stuff in it. So it's not the same type of object. Why isn't it the same type of object? Because we're doing JSON loads on both counts. JSON dump s. So this should just be a string, right? Wow, that's slow. What's going on? It's not that, is it? That is it. Oh, okay. So I was passing it. Okay. I was passing it a string. Dump s goes dump to a string. Right. Gotcha. Okay. See, it's still that JSON jumping back and forth stuff still gets me, obviously. All right. So now how do we figure this out? So I guess you could pass an optional random seed. And use that for making the randomness. One. I don't know what random seeds are supposed to be. Initialize random number generator. If A is omitted or none, the current system time is used. If random sources are provided by the operating system, they're used and set by the system. Okay, whatever. Oh, ugh. I use a random seed function. Random seed. With or optional. Yeah. This is just the docs. Random number with seed 30. Random int. Okay, so you just... I wonder if that goes across files. I would doubt it, but maybe? I don't know. Actually, let's do it here. So let's just see if that compiles. It does. So an MP3 file. random int from 1 to 10. Make it a little easier to find. So we got 3. We got 3. We got 3. Here, let's do this. Like, I'm pretty sure after 3 in a row, so 1 to 100. So 18, 18, 18, 18, 18. Okay, so that's how you do it. Okay. And I kind of hit on that a while ago, but it didn't stick. So that's cool. That's really cool. So that gives you, okay. Now you can have known output and you can target specific things. How, okay. So we're making a note of that. I want to do that in the scratch pad. Test random thing. Random thing dot py, and then test random thing dot py. Use bin environment Python, import unit test, import random class, random thing test, unit test, test case, set up. This is a good way to do this, right? So you have a consistent random seed one. Just who cares? Def test random, not random, random specific random, random specific, random specific random. Names matter to me. And let's just set this up like we normally would, which would be RT random thing with those on it. Class random thing. Def. Specific random. And you're gonna need random up here. Well, are you? Yes, you would need it because you need to have it. Random target. Value equals rand int 1 200 return value. Everything's angry right now. Why is that gray? Unresolved resonance randint. You gotta do random.randint? Test that. One of these days I will remember that I have that. And then if name main, you know, test main go. So let's just see if that's passing. Okay, it is. And so now, RT random thing. Yeah, that's broken. Oh, why didn't that break? Because I'm not calling. I thought it would break in setup if that didn't exist. Wait, why didn't that break? Because it's Ceph up, see? First, make sure the test breaks. There we go. From Ben versus Scratchpad, okay. Still breaking. Attempted relevant with no parent. See, I still don't understand this. So random thing is going, and then we're just gonna do, we'll test to make sure the thing works. Random target. Aha. Global, see, make sure it passes, or like, step by step. That's passing. And then actual, so expected is gonna be, actually don't know what the value is gonna be right now, so we're just gonna do 5. And 5, whatever, except we're gonna do actual equals random target. 18 is not equal to 5. But now we should just be able to hit 18 every single time. Oh yeah, it's actually good too, because we just tested random with 1 and 1 to 100 over on the other thing, and it gave us 18 there too. So 18. New. The other thing I want to start doing. So this is tricky, right? Because I've got the scratch pad stuff, but I've also got my Grimoire, my NVL, my developer notebook, whatever we want to call it. So I'm putting a bunch of stuff in two places, which I'm not a fan of, but I don't have a way to make the other. So the other, I can't make the other thing executable, and I can't make this thing search as fast as the other one. So until we solve for that, that's going to be here. I wonder. You know what you could do? Ooh, okay, this is super interesting. So I could set up a script. That would look through all these things. And just do like pi dash date time stuff. And then just push down all the files. That's cool. So I could do my edits and, oh, that's how you do it. That's how you like bridge the gap. And then that you could push out to the digital garden, right? To the blog. That's cool. I'm gonna do that. automatically push PyCharm. Scratchpad to site with py dash folder name with splits for the files. Readme at top. That's really cool. I like that a lot. I really like that because then I can search for the stuff really fast. And then find it. And then you could potentially link over, like what would be really cool is if you could link back into PyCharm directly. So like if I was in NVAlt, which I think you can turn on links, right? But I don't know if those links make URL links clickable. I don't know if you can link into PyCharm. From any browser, I can type and hit enter or programmatically call with open PyCharm, open file equals file path. This will open PyCharm at the specified file, which is very handy. Some important documentation about the URL schemes, yeah. Okay, so you can do it. Put up my header to open directly from whatever. Solution, which they document page for that. Yeah. Okay. So you can do it. PyCharm open file from URL. According to this page. Yeah, this is cool. I'm really digging the idea of having sorry, I can't do things at the same time. According to this page. So I just do one, whatever, it's fine. These work for opening PyCharm files. But it doesn't tell you how to like open it to a project. That's cool. Anyways, back to this. So functions, method, test things. We need a better word for things. Items, test randomness, test outputs. That include randomness. Yeah, so this is super cool because you can have the README and then you can just order the files That's really cool. So what that would look like would be this. Yeah, this is cool. This is really cool. So this you just need to do from 01 underscore random thing, right? Is this gonna work? Nope. And I missed something. What did I do? Oh, can you not have... Puzzle import Drench's problem. I don't remember. I remember not to name anything with a number. The bunch are correct, but as for now, the recommended way is to use import module function. They don't actually give an example. Imported module, the name argument must be specified. When was this from? 2016. See, this is funny. Don't put does this work. Like, test it. You do puzzle, but see, I don't like... solving a problem that's not yet a problem, but it will be at some point. So, because what I want to be able to do is, well, I guess you could put the order. In the README. Right. Yeah, see, I want as low friction as, well, I recognize I'm completely off the thing here, but like, this is something I've been thinking about and I'm in the middle of thinking about it, so it's good to spend some time on it. Yeah, because I don't want to change the methodology for calling this, right? That needs to just go and work. Because I don't want to alter the files in a way that I wouldn't normally alter them. But what you could do... I guess you can put YAML down at the bottom, right? Can you put YAML at the bottom? I guess you can put YAML at the top. Yeah, you can put YAML anywhere, right? This is really interesting. Like, this is something I've been thinking about a little bit, about, like how to combine these things. Yeah, because then it's executable and it's in there. I really like this. And then you could actually add. Notes at the top or whatever. This, that's starting to get a little bit far up, but like. Now, where am I going to put that? PyCharm executable nvalt pages process to move PyCharm files, PyCharm scratchpad files into nvalt at a directory level. Py folder name, file name, start with readme md. I feel like I want it, so I want to make it Pythonic, right? So you could just do readme md. Process output basic content. Grab YAML at the bottom for outputting the files in their order and with notes. Yeah, so really what you'd want to have is name, note, or somehow you'd want to have, ooh, well, really what I should do is just make it JSON. Except I kind of like Markdown. Oh, well, what you could do random thing that, but then what you could do is random thing dot md, so you could have notes about random thing. Yeah, because you can just click back. I mean, like, these are instant to get to. Yeah, and then that way you've got just the actual code chunk as its thing. Yeah, I like that. I'm excited to work on that. And then that stuff can fly over to figure out how to add notes for each file. First try is just set up MD files with the same names as the .py files. and output them first. That's cool. I'm looking forward to this because this is going to be neat. This is going to be really neat. I like it. What was I doing? Pi random test. Oh, I'll have to figure out how to delete the stuff that's not there anymore. Like if I move something, if I rename it. See. Test random thing. For note on how to use seeds. To get consistent test results. That's really cool. Okay. See, learning. All right, so that's always 18, and then you can. Basics are that you can set a seed inside the test file that makes the file under test produce the same result each time. And now we figured out how to test random. Okay. Glad I got this back under test. Like I've been struggling with that. So I don't have to, and that's really good too, because I don't have to pass an additional flag or do anything else that's altering the way that the actual module works in order to get the consistent test and to get this consistent random, because I can set this up here. And so MNOPQR set random there. Set random seed. We'll do that in setup. Okay, now we can actually figure out how to build the thing. Oh wait, expected should be this. No, load string. Because I want to. What am I looking to do here? I'm looking to. I want to just get a string out of the file. Because I just want to be able to dump. I just want to be able to open it and write it. So this dumps to a string. So this is a string. Okay. And then I'm loading the string each time. Yes, okay, so I'm loading the string each time because that's how I'm going to do the comparison, just to make the comparison easier. Okay. Yes, okay, that's right. So now we can update our expected. Oh, but I can just do JSON load here. If I do this, all right, I think this is gonna work. Nope. List object has no thing read. Oh, load is... Sorry, it just makes it an object. But is there a difference between a regular list and the JSON list? No, not right now. There's not anyways. Okay. So load from string. So we're making an object. We're making a list out of that. Okay. So if our length is 2, we're only going to have one transition. So in here, it's going to be name equals fade. Duration equals 500. So that's going to fail. Took a long time to get here. I'm going to comment all of this out for a moment. Because I just want to get to... Dump S dumps to string, so name, fade, duration, 500. Let's pass. I still don't know why it's taking so long. What do I got going on? Not a lot. I don't see anything that's freaking it out. Okay, so now we can populate this, which is for transition number in range of 1 to length, length. Put a gun to my head. I'm not sure I could ever get that right on the first try. So this is still going to pass because I'm still just doing this down here. I'm just kind of building the structure right now. Why is that so slow? So transition list is a list. Everything is slow right now. I don't understand it. Well, maybe I got a bunch of stuff open. Okay, that's fair. So for there, transition list, append, that, name, fade, duration, 500. So this should still pass because we're not calling it yet. But hopefully what we can do is put this here. Transition JSON equals JSON dot dumps that and see if that goes. Why is that red? Okay. Because I misspelled something. Yep. All right, run that. Is that gonna pass? Okay, that's passed. Okay, cool. So now we got, now we're loading it. Okay, so now we get to figure out just how to make the transition calls or the transitions, whatever. So let's actually name this. Yeah, let's call this transitions. Let's get some better names going here. Or let's improve the name. How about that? Transitions append. Let's bring this back here so we can see it a little better. We don't need to get all whatevered. Where are those red? Okay. So slow right now. Oh, that fat test went instant. So nice. All right, so here's our, whoops. Here's our transition types, which probably should be stored somewhere else, but it's okay. What is that? Oh, I'm doing the split. I'm doing it that way. I gotcha. I'm just doing, instead of making a list with the commas and the quotes, I'm just doing this as splitting on spaces. So for transition and number range. So let me get back to Python random choice is plural. Because this is how you do weighted things. And so let me go back to Scratchpad for a second. New directory. Weighted random choices choices. Read me, read men. .md. Yeah, so now I'm thinking about this a little bit as if I'm publishing this stuff, because this will be published, and like this is actually going into my notes, so these are helpful, and like documentation is a good thing, right? Use random.choices to weight the return probability of random item, whatever. Weighted random choice pi. Import random. So items equals A, B, C, D. And then yeah, so you pass it it's funny for me that this doesn't show you how to just get a single value, which would just be putting a zero on the list, I think. We're going to find out. So for count in range of 1, of 0 to 100, whatever. Print, I just want to see, 1 second. So X, you do end equals nothing, right? Is to get, well, I guess another way to do this would just be outputs equals a list. Outputs append. I'm jumping ahead. I should have just done a single item. Let's just do a single item to start with. Item equals random choices from items, and then weights. So 10, so this is the thing, 10, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So I don't think these numbers have, like, obviously these don't have to end up to 100, but I think you can go over 100 too, is gonna be my guess. So if you really want to push something, you can do like 500 to 1 ratio, right? It should just be ratios, I hope. And then one. So print item. I think this is going to be a list with one item in it. This is going to be nothing before we're given. So do you have to actually do it by named parameters? A, C, A. We should get a lot of A's. Yeah, this is really cool because you can do a little snippet like this. And then we can do weighted random choice CES. Example 2.py, whatever. User bin environment, Python 3, just call it. Import random. Items equals A, B, C, D. Weights equals 10, 5, 2, 1. Wait. So this was, yeah, so really what we want is that. Whoops. That. Going at the first item on the list. We broke it. What did we do? Let's do this and put this in the right place. There you go. So that just pulls it directly out. For print random item in range 0 to 100. Print. So I just want to get a big string of them. And actually, I'm going to do a fun output here, right? Or a whatever output. So. Item equals random choices items weights k equals 1, 0. So do item with end equals nothing, and then if random item if not if note not. Random item divided by 15. Print new line. Get a little space there. Yeah, there you go. So I think you got to start this at 1 and then go to 101 to make that not get that first one. Yeah. Hey, it's a DNA pattern. Yeah, so very few C's. And we should actually look at letters that we can see. A, I, X, Z. Or A, T, C, G. A. I was trying to figure out how to make it easier to see. Oh, that's kind of cool looking. There's some X's, some I's, the occasional Z. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We need to add 5 to that. So 106. Let's get it all straight up. So X, A, A, Z. And so then what we could do, and I'm not going to do this. This is just a test to make sure I got understanding, right? Seed A or 1. So now we should see the same thing every time. So it ends with Z, A, I, I. Ends in Z, A, I, I, Z, A, I, Z, A, I, I. And then if we take that away, we got something completely different. And completely different. And completely different. Okay, so now the other question is, can we do 500? We should see mostly A's. Yeah, there we go. That's funny, we got 2 X's and no I's or Z's. Even though I's have a theoretical higher probability than whatever's. It really likes X today. All A's. There's some I's. Maybe while before we see a Z. Three more times. We'll see if we see a Z. 2 more times. There's a Z. Okay. Sweet. See, this is all... Okay, now what I need to do is go back and look. I had a list somewhere that I put of the transition types that I wanted to use because I don't like them all. But I do not remember where I put that. Is a bummer. Nope. Okay. We'll find it later. Yeah, I just need to make it again. So I gotta, because I want to make sure I'm doing the transitions that I want. So FFmpeg, concat. Let's do that and it'll get there. It's funny because this isn't the right one. It's down here a bit. This one. And then we go GL transitions, I think is the right page. Yeah. Oh, no, wait, hang on. We can actually click on them individually. They're down here. They're there. Fade, grayscale, circle open, directional warp, directional wipe, cross warp, cross zoom. Dreamy, Squarespace, Angular, Radial, Cube, Swap. Oh. So here's some of them he's found particularly useful for quality video transformations. I guess you can do all of them. So we could add whatever we wanted in here. We'll just start with these. This is fine. That's a rabbit hole. Where am I going? I need to come here. I may mess around with that later. So should I set that up as a config? I probably should, but I'm just gonna put it in there for right now. It's fine. That's a transition. So I was like, that doesn't look like my config file. What's going on? Config dev. Transitions. So this needs to be a list. Name. Fade. This needs to be a list of hashes. Name fade. Wait. 100. Code runner. Items equals this for item and items dot split. I want to see if we can do this on slash. Just do this. Does this work? Print item. Oops. There we go. Okay, cool. So that's a good way to get that. So then we can do fstring with, we want to make it this, with name is item, weight is 100. We'll just start everything at 100 and then we'll just in a minute. So let's just do that. Aww. Because we don't have this. Oh, God. The F string, it's got this. It doesn't like this. Can we escape those? No. Can we double escape those? Let me look this up. Python fstring that escape curly. People have searched for this before. You need double. I don't think that's really what I'm looking for. You escape it by doubling the braces. Double? 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 That's it. Okay, can you just escape one of them? Or does it have to match? Okay. Good to know. Oops, definitely needs to be inside here. Oh, we need a comma at the end of it. And we could do a join if we really wanted to do this. Oh, actually, let's see if we can one line this. I'm not gonna worry about that. I know you can. I am not gonna worry about it. So we don't need that. Let's get this going over here just so they're all formatted the same. We don't need this one. I don't know why those are all green. What does that mean? Typo. Okay, sure. Oh, but now you gotta load this. What I do want is a config. Oh, I just made it more complicated. Transitions. So this is going to explode because we're not calling transitions yet. Transitions is a list. Dictionary. We'll give it a couple of these. It's kind of gross. Oops. Why isn't that going to, it's not hitting a mark. There we go. Undo that last one, do that. So there's transitions. And while we're at it, we're gonna just load that. And then we're gonna pass that when we make the MP3 files. Just so we're ahead of the game on that. Build concat.json. Okay. This is definitely taking longer than I expected, but that's okay, because we took some side trips. Alright, I'll be right back. I should absolutely get one of those digital thermometers in here so I can see, or like networked thermometers or whatever, so I can see how warm it is, because it's a little toasty. I should put another one on the other side of my house where the AC thing is and see what the diff is. Because it's a few degrees at least. All right, let's see if we just test this. What happens? Go. Oh. Ran all the tests. Didn't mean to do that. Definitely broke some stuff. All right. Which one broke? No such file or directory. NASA dev, NASA simpler tests, output root. So this is trying to actually make a file. It's kind of bad for a test. Am I on the test file? Yeah. NASA dev, NASA assembly tests, clip root. Okay, we moved this. No, it's here, clip root. MP3 root, MP3 path, output root, tests, output. That should have worked. Switch file directory, open transitions JSON. This is the integration test, right? Is that what's happening? Open file. Root, make video. Just run this one. One test. What happened? No such file or directory. Temp4. Okay, so it's not making that. Oh, because I've got all this stuff. Oh, I goofed. I definitely goofed. I got way away from green. I should not have done it this way. We're going to go back. So I'm going to comment all this out. I'm going to uncomment this. I'm going to uncomment this. This was our original stuff. I should have built this as another method. I was not thinking right. So we're going to skip this one for now. Empty suite. That's not cool. Empty suite. What's going on? Oh, I'm still on PyFakeFS. I need to get off of that. If I test this, does that go? Empty suite. What is going on? Oh, unit test is not defined. Oh. Because I started this on PyFakeFS. I thought I was going to be able to do some of this stuff without having to hit the file system, but I have to use some external tools and do some other stuff, so that just did not work. So we comment, we try again. I want to get back. I want to make sure I'm green. I'm not green right now. Okay. I don't want to be working on the other thing if this isn't working, and this isn't working. Crap. Okay. I gotta figure out what I did. See, I did it backwards. I did it wrong. List index out of range, transition types, whatever. Okay. Let's find the first error. All right, actually, let's find the first thing. See which tests are wrong. Test duration. Are you good? You're good. Test ffmpeg command. You good? Nope. During handling. See the difference. Oh, wow, I didn't. This was broken last night, and I didn't test it. I put in the fade last night, but I didn't put it in the test. That is another thing where I goofed. Let me just look at these. That's gonna be super small on stream. Sorry about that. It's not getting any smaller than that. I can't see the thing across. Oh, that's hysterical. That is a very long command. Whoa. I think that's about right. It on the eyes. I'm not running this as a command, so I'm not going to worry about the slashes right now. I'm just trying to see what's going on with it. It's all that middle stuff that's going to change. Because that's where we add the fade. Fade in and fade out. Filter complex. Here's all of our fun stuff. Gotcha. Okay, so basically, we want to do start with that CV, right? Yeah, CV. To here, because we're not doing shortest. Duration, does these we can escape, right? I hope we can escape these. There's probably one more of them back here. No, I'm not. No, there shouldn't be. Because that's. I'm only fading the video. I'm not worrying about the audio because I'm overlaying the audio. Ah, crap. I was optimistic. Boop, 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 boop. Did I miss a space? What happened? Wait, those looked identical. Okay, take two. Complex filter, we go to the maps. And then we'll go to the last one, or the shortest. I like having a dash there. So here's our eye. Here's our eye. Here's our complex. Here's our map. Here's our shortest. I don't see it. Step two. So save this. Where's my desktop? Where's my desktop? There we go. 1.txt. 2.txt. Desktop. Open diff 1, 2. Whoops. That's gonna freak it out. Try that. Zero differences. That is not helpful. Oh, it's a new line. Where's that new line coming from? And why didn't that get hit earlier? Wait a minute, was that on the right page? Okay, put that in. I need to get out of that. Get out of that. Deal with that in a second. Get out of that. I feel like I've made a whole bunch of changes without committing anything. That's dynamic. Main's gonna sit there. There's a new line. Yeah, oh, that's why it didn't catch it, because I didn't do tests on it. It was late and I was not doing well. I mean, I was doing fine, but like I wasn't what wasn't I doing? I wasn't functioning well. Test integration. So this one I think still fails. Unless it doesn't be. Oh, I was hoping the other thing fixed it. List index out of range. Clip duration. Okay, so let's get a So I don't think it's this. Get duration of clip, I'm pretty sure it's okay. Make video. It's gonna be somewhere. Whoops, look at that. That I'm not a fan of most of the time. Especially because I can never tell what triggers it. Print. Turn. Else. Like. Show context actions. No context actions. Okay, whatever. List index out of range. So. Range of 1 to length. Random transitions. Aha. This needs to be length minus 1. I think that was it. I should move this integration test off to its own file. I'm gonna commit this stuff first and do that. Because otherwise, if I accidentally need to do it, it runs. Hey, Velcro, what's up? So you're hallucinating again. I tell you, gotta watch out for that sleep stuff. It's amazing what a night of well-restedness can do for you. Alright, so I think this is passing, so I'm gonna go ahead and start committing all this stuff that I haven't committed. That's on splitter, we don't need that. Assembler. Ew, I made a bunch of stuff. So, here... add transitions. Add to-do list. I need to ignore this file. This is a... ignore dynamic build transitions file. Yeah, I stream a lot these days. It's cool because like I don't get to do this type of work at work, and I'm really liking this type of work, and I'm really liking this thing that I'm working on. So like, I'm gonna stream a lot, and COVID's happening, so it's not like I can go anywhere. Yeah, I don't know if I would have really started streaming if it wasn't for COVID. Guess that's a good thing that came out of it. Yeah, so not everything bad is all bad. So like, look for the bright side. I mean, obviously people have died. And that is no good. All right, did this finish? No, it's still going. Yeah, we're definitely gonna move that out to its own file. So NASA Assembler MP3. Oh yeah, I went all over the place on this one. So that's add debugging message. I don't know why these things are here. Smoke test. I'll just ignore this one. Ignore file. Ignore temporary build transitions file. So NASA assembler, pass transitions to MP3. And actually, let's make sure that accept it. Pass transitions to MP3. Add random seed to tests. And then this hopefully is, so that's not gonna happen yet. That can actually all stay the same because that didn't change. That didn't change yet. This doesn't change yet. Concat command. This is all fine. This is what changed. Update FFmpeg call to do fade in and fade out. And then all the rest of this stuff is still in progress. Oh yeah, so do this. Set overfill on video to 40 seconds. Concat command, where'd that go out? Self build concat command. Concat command equals self build. Oh, okay, so this becomes this. Call transitions file with concat. This is all what we're doing next. And that is what we're doing next. Okay, so that's in the mix. After all that, it failed? You gotta be kidding me. Probably couldn't write to the output directory. False is not true. Self assert path, output path is file. Output file. So that makes the integration. Pass remove output file. Yeah, it's not the temp file. It's the final file. Yeah, make video does all of it. Let me just make sure that's right. Make video. Yeah, okay, yeah. So that was just, it was pointed at the wrong file. I'm not gonna rerun that. In fact, what I'm gonna do is as assembler tests. New file. Test MP3. Integration py. Use bin environment Python 3, import unit test. I'm going to switch this to unit test. Class MP3 test, unit test, test case, def setup. I'll just leave that there for a second. That there for a second. If name equals main, I think I've already got a hotkey to make that go, but whatever. Unit test main go. Doesn't take that long to type. So we need path. We need MP3, which I'm just going to steal this one to grab it because I don't remember which way to do it. From NASA Assembler, there we go. So, global MP3 equals GLOBAL. Let's spell it right. global mp3 file go. We need OS. Import OS. So the other thing in test file is we gotta send all this jazz to it. Which is a heck of a setup. I don't know if that's a code smell or not. Maybe, probably is. Oops. Import random. Output. Okay, let's see if that works. Yeah, this one takes a few minutes to run, but it's the integration test, so that's allowed. Yeah, the other good news is I've been running the process that does the clipping on the other machine. And it looks like it's still streaming. I wasn't sure if all that processor was going to eat up and make it not stream well, but the status is green, so I guess it's working okay. Yeah, it's got a long way to go. So out of 256 folders, each of which has probably, each of which probably has one or two in it, it's on like folder 12. And there's probably only 200 folders so far, but like there will be 256 eventually. So it's going to take some processing time. All that work I did trying to get up on Amazon, like still, like I'm not even going to try that just because even if the fastest, I may try some to see what the speed differentials are, but even at its fastest, it's still going to be days and days. And like those boxes, like the high power boxes are like $4 an hour. So like times 24 hours is 80, 96 bucks. I'm not going to pay $100 a day for stuff when this can do it. And if it takes five times as long, who cares? I'm just paying for the electricity. All right, so there's our transitions and weights. Oh, I know what I was gonna do. So I can do this while that's going on. I figure out which transitions I want. So fade is definitely in. Gray fade I don't like. Gray fade goes away. Circle open is cool, but like weight of 5. Directional warp is cool, but 1. And this is directional wipe, I think. Ooh, see, that looks better. Five. Cross warp, I don't really like. I'm going to take cross warp out. Cross zoom. Nope. Dreamy. Nope. Square wire. Definitely don't want that very often, but that's in the mix. Angular. So I think the other ones, yeah. We don't want angular, but radial's okay. No angular. Radial. 5. Cube is also gonna be like a 1. No. Yeah, a 1. And swap. Okay, so no swap. So the weight of these 5, 10, 15, 16, 17, 18 plus 100. That would still be like 10% of the time for those. So, and there's 40 videos or 40 clips per thing. So that would be 4 of those in there. No, that's way too many. So 818. I don't know how to do that math. If there's 800, well, so if there's 40. So 800 if there's 40 clips, right? It would be, that would be 0.2% chance of getting in. But how do you do the weight? How'd you do that math? So it's 818. 40 divided by 818. So there's a 0.4% chance for any one of them. We'll call it 0.5, whatever. 0.5, so. Nope. So if there's 0.4. Or 0.04. This makes more sense. 0.05, whatever. Times 800. No, that's only 40. .4. Okay, and then 0.048 times 18. Is 0.8. So I think that means there will be one of those interesting or one of those other transitions per video if we do 800 on an average of 40 clips. Which is that? I'm trying to figure out. That's probably about right. I'm just trying to think of like what the user experience would be for the clips. All right, so that passed. Okay, so we got everything lined up now. So the integration's passing. So let's do this. Set up for target transitions. And then, so integration. Ripped all that out. move migration test to its own file. Let's just look at that for a minute and do a sanity check on it. Assembler, tests, output root, hyperspeed. So there's our fade in. Our fade in was a little slow, actually. Yeah, we need to speed that up. All right, we'll do that right now. As soon as we sign the FFmpeg command. So this is gonna break again, but that's cool. Yeah, fade in, let's do 2 seconds. Gonna run another integration on it. That's gonna eat itself real quick. Hang on. Output root. Oh, it already ate itself. Too slow. Also, if we test this, it's gonna freak out because the file is a different whatchamacallit now. The FFmpeg command's different. But we know what's going on now, so hopefully we can fix this really quick. FFmpeg. Duration is 2 on the end. And actually we should be 3. No. So hang on, I want to do 4 seconds is probably going to be too long on the output. So duration for the output, we'll do 3 seconds and 3 minus 3, which means this test needs to be 3 and 105, maybe? Is that right? Yes, okay. And let's just make sure we're in there, right? So make it break. 106, 105. Oh yeah, sure, let's see what you got. Copy link. Standby. Oh, you're these over here? Or you're just general? Yeah, I like it. That looks good. It's nice and clean. I like clean design. About the only thing I might try to experiment with, and again, I'm not really a designer, so take this with a grain of salt, but it's like the names are lined up. I'm not sure what the names are referencing in their horizontal and their vertical alignment. So I might try moving the names over a little farther to, you know, about here, just because it's kind of acts as a header, but it's pushed over a little bit to the whichever way that is. But other than that, I think it's sharp. And so in your design, the other thing I would do is when you comp it, I'd comp one with what happens if you have multiple lines. So like, what are you working on today? And then, and how is it going or something? So that you see a line break. Because you want to know where the headshot position is in when it breaks, right? Or like when there's a break in the line to a new line. And I might not put the colons behind it. But again, these are all like all very personal choices. But like you know that it's John's, like it's more of a label than a, I don't know what the word is for when you have the colon stuff going. That's where my head's at on that. Line breaks? Yeah. That'll get you. It's that kind of stuff is so easy to not get in your head when you're first starting or like when you're first working on a design. That's super easy to miss. I've missed that type of stuff all the time. All right, test passed. Okay, cool. So let's look at our integration here. See what's going on. We can get rid of these. Those are the test files that we had. That's cool. They worked. Where are we going? Dev. NASA assembler. NASA tests output. Oh, it didn't clear temp. Why didn't it clear temp? Also, why is that broken? What just happened? Oh, integration's probably... Oh, I think... Did I run... I ran another test in the middle of this one, didn't I? Or is that what happened? I don't know what happened. Because it definitely broke. In a way that I've not seen before. Oh, please don't break in ways that I haven't seen before. Is that blue? Oh, it's the line I'm on. Ah, whatever. It's funny, I haven't actually made that much progress on the explicit thing that I was working on, but I've made a lot of progress on the stuff around it, which I'm fine with. Like, it's progress. It's all progress. So that was the fades. Did I change the output fade duration to? I don't remember if I did. Oh, yeah, I did, because it's three here and three there. Okay. What I'd like to see is, like, a little bit of a curve where you have like a kind of a slow fade and then it speeds up right towards the end, which I'm sure there's a way to do that. You can make this program dance like anything if you know the magic incantations. All right, so now I can't run a test yet because it'll break again or it'll stop it again. But what I really want to do, so here's where I goofed. This should be build concat test v2 because I want to keep everything else green and then move to this. So I'm going to go ahead and start moving that over. Let's also make it an actual thing. Build concat JSON v2 self go. Return. True, whatever, it's fine. Hey, protocol's in the house. What's up? How goes it on your side of the sun? The world, the environment, the daylight? I've got nothing. Nothing. How are you doing this fine, hopefully fine day? Is it a fine day over there? May it be a fine day for you. I need like a toast, right? I should have a whole bunch of toasts that I should be able to pull off. Oh, whoops. Did I go through all those? Yeah, I did. Okay. I'll leave this open. Good toasts. 27 best toast while drinking from Food Beast. Interesting name. Interesting logo. Ah, salute. Here's those who've seen us at our best and seen us at our worst and can't tell the difference. Weak. To the wives and girlfriends, may they never meet. Uh-huh, old, yeah, whatever. Tabs and friends, that's a good one. This is waiting on an integration test to run, by the way. So I can't mess with anything else because it'll throw this test off and or it'll throw the build off. Oh, actually, I guess I can cut and paste all this stuff into the right place. I finally figured out how to test some randomness by using a seed so that you get the same value back from the random thing, which I've been struggling with for, you know, weeks. Playing about with Ansible, nice. Which one's Terraform? Is Terraform like the group thing? Ansible's more individual servers, and Terraform is like cluster type stuff. Cloud infrastructure. Okay, yeah. Have you ever done any of the Amazon stuff with like CloudFormation? Because I think is CloudFormation in the same category as Terraform? I'm increasingly spending time in the Amazon infrastructure. So like their tools are like, and I don't do very much of this stuff at all. I do zero of this stuff at all. I'm interested in it, but tools like CloudFormation, Heat, etc. allow the details of an infrastructure to be codified in a config file. A config file allows the infrastructure to be elastically created, modified, and destroyed. Terraform is inspired by the problems they solve. Similarly, uses config files, but goes further by being both cloud agnostic and enabling multiple providers and services to be combined. Oh, okay. So that's cool. Okay. Right, so CloudFormation is basically, Cloudflare for DNS, or DNS Simple for CDN services. Yeah, okay, that's super cool. That's worth looking at, because I've used, not Cloudflare, Cloudinary as CDN before. Huh, okay, that's really interesting. I'll have to look at that. And again, if you're playing around with it, is it personal stuff or still work stuff or just kind of messing with it in general? I'm tied up right now. There we go. Yep, okay. Same, right? It's kind of all like, and it's interesting to tell this to people who aren't computer people, right? It's like pretty much any time I'm on a computer is kind of work stuff, but kind of personal stuff in terms of like figuring stuff out and doing. I mean, sometimes it's like obviously one or the other, right? But oh, cool, right on. Yeah, that's a little bit of what I mean, right? So like the learning of the thing, it's like, when I'm learning a tool, it's both, but it's like its own thing. It's like the toolkit thing. Speaking of which, I need to name that differently. Oh, okay, so now it's working. Let's see if it doesn't explode this time. I think I killed this test last time and it freaked out. So I've got most of this stuff working. I'm just setting up to do some to randomize the transitions between the clips, and then I want to randomize the length of the clips or the length of the transitions, because like if I have a 2 second clip, I don't want to have a 2 second transition, because then you wouldn't see anything. Ooh, look at that, testing passed. Three birds, one stone. Ah, that's pretty good. I hadn't thought about three birds, one stone before. That's pretty good. I've always thought two, right? But yeah, stream, work, personal. Yeah, and so like my stuff right now with the stream, right? I've been working on this for a couple weeks. It's just like, pick a thing and go. I basically just was like, okay, I'm gonna try this and go and see what happens. And then also, like, it's been, I think you've seen part of it in terms of, like, I don't know what I'm doing with a bunch of it, so there's a whole bunch of me trying to figure stuff out, which I don't know if that's boring or not. It will be just part of the process. All right, let's see what this actually did. Does this intro look better? Wow, I still want it to be faster. Space Chicken. Oh, it did a random transition. That was one of them. And that was one of them. Wow, it shouldn't have done that many. So I can turn that down a little bit. And the wipe, ha, it's, whoa. It's doing way too many. And another wipe? No, something's wrong. It's not doing the waiting. Oh, I haven't put in the waiting yet. That's why. Well, no wonder. Now we get to put in the waiting. All right, let's see where we are. Leave that there for now. Leave this for now. Okay, that's what we're working on. So, but we'll do this for. Oh, actually, I want to do one more refinement of ye old FFmpeg command. So the question is, can we do. I'll bet you can do like 1.2 seconds, right? Surely. Oh, you know what I might, can I just do, I can run this separately, right? Let me see, NASA assemble videos. It automatically went in the virtual environment. I love Pi NV now. That is super cool. Tests, because it's in, it thinks it's in test directory. No, it doesn't know where it is. Okay, whatever. We're just gonna try and run it from here. Is that gonna work? No. Integration. Crap. See, all this import stuff. That is bothersome. Like, it works inside, and I think there's a way, like, you can install the module and then run the tests with it, but only install it locally. I don't know, it's a weird, but yeah, let's see if we can do that. Pip install editable. So run NASA assembler, so that's it, right? Nope. Okay. All right, I'm not gonna mess with that right now. It's fine. It'll deal with it. All right, so for our JSON coming back with concat 2. So let's see, this is gonna break. Because we want to do this to start with. Got unexpected keyword length. Yeah, so we need length and durations. So we'll put those in up here. Bring us down a little bit so I can see more lines. Length, durations. All right, so now we should get a different error. Whoops, where did that go? Oh, there it went. And I lied, we're gonna move that back up a little bit. Yeah, so we're not passing JSON back. So let's just do this, because we had this partially going before we realized we were doing it completely wrong. Also, we need to pass in the transitions in a second, but we'll do this step by step. Okay, so we're passing there. That's good. And we've got access to transitions up here. That's the run. Yep. Okay, so we don't need these. Transitions for transitions number. Here's where we're gonna get our transition. So transition, S-I-T-I-O-N, name equals self transitions, and we're gonna pick rand int no we need to do a random choice. Okay, how do we, okay, slowly but surely that's how we're gonna do this. Dude, I've got to get new music. Like, I've got a bunch. I just need to go through it and pick some stuff. But, like, I've got a giant playlist of stuff, but so much of it's crap that it breaks my concentration. So, yeah, new music's coming at some point. But, yeah, this one and one or two of the other ones just completely stand out. Okay, so where was the, so transition name is random dot choices from self. Oh, transitions is crap. What's the right way to do that? Because I'm passing in transitions with names and weights. Oh, it's still just a number of items. That's fine. Oh, but no, it's not, because I got to get... Crap, how do you do that? For transition... details in self transitions transition items. So we need transition items. Items is a list and transition weights is a list. This is kind of gross, but that's okay. append, transition details, name, and then transition weights, append, transition details, weight. So that makes our two lists that we can get. Where are those? There we go. Okay. That makes our two lists that we can actually use for the random pull. Random choices. I don't have random yet, do I? Transition items. Weights equals transition weights. Oops. K equals 1, 0. Okay, does this compile? No. We blew something up. Can only concatenate string, not int to string. All right, where did we go wrong? First, that needs to be that. Does that work? Is that what it was? Okay, maybe that's what it was. Random transition, oh, weights. There we go, try that. So I'm trying to get a weighted, like I want, most of the time I want just a basic fade. But sometimes I want to have the other ones go, but I don't want an even distribution. So let's put that in there and let's see. So this may break because it may give us a different. Okay, so that gave us fade. And now I just want to see a different number. Or I want to see a different weight. So if I change the config, I'll change this to 1. Still got it. If I change this to 2. Still got it. Okay, something's funky. That shouldn't have happened. I don't think that should happen. Transition F transition name. Fade. Maybe this is getting fade every time. Wait, 3. I mean, that can happen. Seems unlikely, though, at this point. Where'd it go? Oh, that's the tests. Sorry. So that's still fade, right? Yeah, it's still fade. Okay, let's try something different, which is, let's put this back at 800. No, let's put this at 1. 4 transition number and range. That's it. All right, let's actually debug. What do you say we debug? Get better at debugging, or get better at using debug instead of print. Weights are all 100. Why is that all 100? They should be. Oh, wait. Oh, yeah. Okay. So I wasn't changing. That gets set up here. So they've all got 100% chance, or they're weighted evenly. Yeah, I wasn't actually changing anything. Okay, that's why it kept giving me the same number. Makes sense. Yay, debug. So now, if we actually go change the seed and run it, test failed. Give me a different name. Direction wipe. Okay, perfect. If we do it again, we should get direction wipe again with another fail. Sweet. And let's just put that in as our test just to make sure we understand the logic. We run this. There it goes. Okay, cool. Sweet. Okay, so that's working as much as we can test random. So that's dropping our JSON. We're not dealing with the durations yet, but I want to go ahead and get this kicked out to where it's making the file. Build concat JSON. Concat command, build concat JSON. So this, we're actually just going to do. We're not going to call it build. We're just going to call it concat JSON v2. There's surely a better way to do this. Yeah, the better way would be split this out and just have like a give me a random thing. But really, this should just be called concat JSON because we're not building it, we're just grabbing it. So we're going to do this. And we're going to do this. We're going to run. We're gonna run the full thing. See if we broke anything else. Nope, we didn't. Okay, so. Oh, yeah, let me do this. Reduce that to 1.2 seconds, and then here is all the stuff where oops, yeah, should have done that in that update ffmpeg to 1.2 sec fade in. Set up the load JSON file for transitions. Let's actually apply some stuff and do that. There we go. All right, so now we got our weighted random transitions going. We just have to write it out to the file. And again, all this stuff should be split up. This is not cool, but I've made some progress here. Next, what we can do is with open. Is this where we run it? Return concat command. No. Okay. Crap. So I guess we set that as an environmental variable. So when we do the move or we do the make, we actually output it at that point. So let's set up for that. So when we make, when we build, so actual, how are we going to do this? I guess we don't want to pass these. We want to give them. Crap. I should split this out, but I'm not going to. Like, with concat command. I mean, it's already building it right here anyways. So with open transitions.json. As transition file. Transition file write self concat.json v2. With all that jazz. Is that all gonna go away and work? Okay. So let's run all of our tests and see if that explodes. Nope, okay, and let's run the integration at this point. Yeah, gotta run it again. I just wanna see, I need to see if that's working. No, exploded hard. Transition file, write IO unsupported operation, not writable. Did I type something wrong? Nope. Aha. We shall make it writable. Okay, so that should have made the JSON. Actually, I should put that in there. Yeah, this is still ugly, but like I'm walking that balance of like where you find. I didn't quite get it right the first time. I didn't get it right the first time. So like, where's the value in going back and doing that this on this one? Or because like I said, I've already made a lot of progress in the way that I'm doing this stuff. There's our transitions. Circle, fade gray circle. Wait. Fade gray circle. Oh, this is still coming off of the test. This isn't coming off of, yeah. This isn't coming off of my weighted, it's not coming off my config file that has the different weights in there. That. Also, I might as well clear these pip things or pep things, pep 8, whatever it is, while it's working. 100, 15, 15, 15, 15. Pick the shortest MP3 file I have, but like, I still want to do a full integration run on it, so. I kind of don't want to mess around with anything else because as soon as I start going somewhere else, I'm going to lose my track again. So this is cool. This is fine for now. Don't close that. Don't close that. You can close this one because that's the one that we just made. Mainly, I just want to see if this all works or if the thing that I did breaks it. Actually, I guess it looks like it's already working because it's doing the transcoding, so that's probably in good shape. He says, jinxing it. Got a cat command. So we've got the build, so we should actually be able to get rid of all this. I'm not going to take it out yet. Yeah, I should have done that before on this integration test. Ooh, yeah. You don't want that there either. That would have exploded. Skip anything where the video didn't need the cutscenes. Yeah. Clip duration. So how do we, so the next thing I want to do is the math behind, this is funny because all I'm doing is messing with the transitions. But like, I think that's important. I mean, clearly it's important. I need to go watch more TV and see how transitions work. Because I don't think they, like... I think most of the time they're just smash cuts. And how would you do... So I've got the durations coming in. I'm trying to figure out. So like one of the things I want to do is I don't want to have like a 1 second transition over a 2 second clip. But I want some of the transitions to be longer. And I guess what you could do is in the config file, you could put like a min time and a max time for the transitions and then pull randomly from that. I think I like that. Because like circle open, you don't want to hit 0 seconds, or like you don't want to be a smash cut because then you'd never see it. And this is where I started making. Storage fade tests. Nope. Transitions. Yeah, see, I started making these transition tests, which I really should have used shorter clips. I may go back and actually make shorter clips. See that circle open at 900 milliseconds. What was the longest one that I did? Oh, I did 10 seconds, so that's why. These are ridiculous. That's kind of cool, actually. So that video is 20 seconds long. Hang on a second. How long is this one? 30 seconds long. Yeah, so a 10-second animation cuts 5 off of each clip. But like this will be a smash cut. Bloop. And that's why, so what I want to know is like, is that really how TV cuts, or is it more like 300 milliseconds? So you get like a little bit of a, ooh, that's kind of cool. Now it's just figuring out how I want to do all this stuff, right? Well, I need to put the logic in place and then I can play with the details. Yeah. Min time 0. Max time. Yeah, that's why I need all these. I thought I took gray out of there. I did. Okay. It's like this a 6-second transition here for fade. It's too much. All right, I'm just gonna put in 1,000 milliseconds for each of them. First, let's go look and see what that one did. Dev, NASA assembler, tests, NASA, nope, tests, output, go. I just want to make sure, this one is just a test to make sure it works. Okay, see, that's better. 1.2 seconds up front is fine. That's looking pretty sharp. That's looking pretty sharp. I'm digging that. Weighted transition. Using weighted transition times. Oh, actually, hang on a second. I need to run one more integration test after I took all that stuff out just to make sure nothing explodes. Actually, no, I don't. That anymore, huh? Or that? Okay, get those out of there. Fine, cool. Okay. So let's pull this. Setup for weighted times. Should all still pass, right? Because it's just going into... Whoa, why did that explode? Oh, because it got a different number. Well, that's going to give us today. Expected, and we got radial. All right, cool. Radial it is. That's very slick. I like this. So now set up for min max times. Now how do we, what's the logic for the times is gonna be the question. And this is where, like, there's not a good way for me to test, right? Because it's going to be some random thing coming in, so it's just whatever I do it, I'll test it a few times and then make sure it stays the same. So transition items, transition name. Random choices, transitions items, transition name. Oh, this is tricky. I guess one way you could test this would be to just set the min-max of a specific duration or a specific thing and then find it and make sure that it was like that number. But then you also need to take into account the duration of the clip. This is where I can get super complicated. I need to figure out where my threshold of complication is here. Threshold of complication, a memoir. Yeah, so it's picking. It's picking the items. So really what I need, all right, so hang on a second. So if we do, so I want the weights, but really what I want to get then is the nut, because I need to get all this other stuff. So what I really need to do is transition package. Mm. random choices. And this should give me the same thing. Because I've pulled out the weights. So transition package num. And then transition name. V2 is self transitions. This is getting kind of complicated. Transition package num name. Print. Oh, actually, I can just test it, right? That's why we have tests. I don't know which test it needs to be. We're just gonna test them all. Nope. Blowed up. The indexes must be indexes or slices, not indexed. Okay. So I can always get back to green right here. So I'm just gonna mess with this. Let's put a debugger in here. Transition package num. Oh, I'm getting the full thing back. So that should have the name in it. Name, radial, okay. Press continue. Resume program. Resume program. All right, run it. See what happens. There we go. Okay. And then I should be able to get rid of this and this. Okay, I gotta go in just a minute. So radial 800 801, because that's the one that's being called. Yeah, how do you, I'll figure that out later. Let's just do a number in between these numbers. Duration time equals rand int. Min time, max time. duration equals duration time. So this is gonna be either 8 or 801, we hope. Why isn't that going away? Go away. Thank you. 800. Where's our test? Come here, test. Whoops. That was way off. Got inverted. So if we run that. Yeah, we run the full set of tests. Run the full set of tests. Oh, I think I just did. Okay. So this should let us put in. So fade minimum 0 to 400. Circle open, we want to do 900 milliseconds to, we'll just do one for right now, that's fine. Because we need to put in, wait, the random transitions, that's done. Make sure transition times are less than 1/2 length of clip. Of surrounding clips. Yeah, I'm gonna stream tonight. Probably, well, I don't know. I got some work stuff to do, even though I'm on theoretically on vacation. I don't know how like that is gonna go. If assuming I still have any energy after that, I will be back on tonight. I'm guessing around 8 o'clock Eastern time, which is -5 right now from UTC. Oh shit, I gotta go in a second. I wanna finish this up first and then do a run. Directional warp needs to go from 1 second to 1.5 seconds. That can be 1.5, sure. Wipe 400 milliseconds through 102, whatever. Square wipe, square wire, 1 second. 1400 to 1500. Like we want to see that actually go. Radial, similar thing. 1 second to that. Cube 600 to 700. I want that to go fast. And then we're gonna set the weight here to 10. So it's mainly fades. Or so it's not nearly as much all fades. All right, so this is integration. So tests are passing, right? Test passing. 6 tests passed, all right. Well, let's see what happens.
Now I should look and see how many days in a row I've streamed. It's a bunch.
Okay, so that's cool. What was my other list? So, oh yeah, so I need to make, so this is one of those, like, now that I've got the thing going, it's just, I keep adding stuff to it, but that's cool. It's like feature enhancements, right? So a whole bunch of the videos that came down are longer than 10 seconds, so I need to write another app that clips them down to 10 seconds and puts them in the mix. Fade in, fade out, done. Random transitions, done. So, cool. Make sure transitions are less than 1/2 surrounding clip. Set up random times for the transitions. We did that. Add feature that looks at the length of clips to make sure the transitions associated with their appropriate lengths. Yeah, so that'll kind of be in there too. These two would be related. And what I mean by that is like if it's only a 3-second clip. Well, yeah, so it kind of goes related. But like if it's a 3-second clip, make sure it's a smash cut, basically. Switch min video time to 2 seconds. I think I did that. That's just play configuration stuff. I should make that config. Log output to see what's up with each clip. Yeah, I didn't do that. Hey, look, I spelled length wrong again. All right. I'm really glad I got this solved for solving for how to test random. That was a struggle. I kept running into that. And even though I read a couple times about the seed stuff, it never clicked in for how to do it. Even though I think I talked about it at one point. Just one of those things took a few times to get through the skull. This is all good. Just do some pep 8 cleaning up here. Peep 8, pep 8, how do you sell it? Yeah, this one's kind of ugly. That's still a lot too much going on down there. But again, like I'm comfortable with it. I'm gonna get rid of this. I've got tests behind it. It's working. It's not as atomic little atoms as you would like, but it's a functioning. Tire deals, all right. Well, that's pretty cool. Well, I guess I should be careful with these. Some of these may get me kicked off Twitch. Write on their blogs more. Says me, who doesn't write on his blog all that much, but you know, whatever. 95%. All right, making progress. Yeah, I'm pretty excited about this. This is cool. Like, this is doing the thing, right? This is. The quality of this video is way higher. Even just the fade in just made a huge difference. Even though it's only the ins and the outs of it. Oh, now it's got to make it. This is where it adds the MP3 file in. Should see it actually getting made, I think. Dev, assembler, tests, output root. Yep, there's our temp file. And here's our target file. I did a little reading last night about how keyframes work a little bit in like the I and the B and the P frames or whatever, and how there's like main images that are basically JPEGs and pings, and then one type of transition that only looks at the file behind it, and then another type of transition that looks at the one behind it and the one in front of it and does some math there. It's like craziness. Gives me a little more of an idea for why video encoding takes so long, but like all the different formats and all the different whatevers, it just seems crazy. So this is taking longer than expected. Testbast. There's a video. Crossing fingers. It's a pretty good start. I wonder if we'll see the square one go. There's gonna be lots of weird talking stuff that happens in this when there's no voices going on. Great ending, but it's not the end. This is cool. Was it really gonna fade out right there on that one? That was pretty good. All right, I'm happy with that. I am happy with that. I think it's working. It's tough to tell. I guess what I could do is like set all the times to be like 10 seconds or something, and then you can watch them go that way. Set up for all right, cool. That's gonna do it for now. I gotta go do some work. But that's in pretty good shape. Yeah, it's in really good shape. I like that. I think the only real thing I want to do next is make sure the transitions don't overwrite, so I can like do like a longer like 10 second thing or whatever. Yeah, same thing. And then maybe I'll add logging stuff. Maybe. Should have done it at the start, but I don't know how to really log yet in Python, so whatever. Oop, that one just jumped too. Cool. All right, that's gonna do it for now. Take it easy, take care, and we'll see you later. Later tonight if you're around. Then later if not. Bye. Also, that didn't actually end. I need to end the thing. See ya.